Does she leave behind? And when you're ready, staying with your intention, starting to get to know her with your lips. Welcome, everybody. It's a great honor to be here today as a community of beautiful souls and in the mode of curiosity and discovery. These events are always unique. I never know how it's going to go. So we're all going to go on this adventure together. And the beautiful part is we're all going to co-create it together. So many unique voices, so many unique energies. And the idea with the sacred song circles is not to be a musician or to be a good singer or to be anything other than yourself. The idea is that you're a human, but you're a divine human. And from that divine humanity, you also have divine energy coming through you. And so sound is just energy. And in ancient societies and many indigenous societies even today, they still use sound. Everybody in the society, everybody in the community, gathering to sing around the fires. And this is something that is so coded in our DNA that once we start today, you're going to feel it, you're going to remember. And so part of the experience is the remembering. This will feel familiar. This will feel like home to many in our souls, in our bodies, in our hearts. So whatever expectations we brought, let's try to just leave them at the door and to enter this dimension of presence where we can explore whatever wants to be felt today. And the songs I've gathered are songs from all around the world, from all sacred traditions, in all languages. We might not understand every word, but we can feel most of the words. Try to see with an open heart what will come. And a lot of the activations start with activating the elements. So the water, the fire, the air. If you didn't get, and please keep these, I'd like them back at the end. Keep them safe, Jenny. Activating the elements so that we can really get to know the parts of us, the harmony in us. And usually when there's something out of balance in our world, in our life, in our bodies, something with the elements that's out of balance. So we are re-singing harmony back into the body. Mahmoud? With the reading. So can somebody put a light just in the back so that those in the back can have a different light? And you can use your phone light, Shui. And a lot of these songs, they are mantras, they are chants, which means they're very, very simple. Anybody can sing them, anyone can play them on the guitar. And so the idea is to maybe read it once, get it, and then try and do it without a paper, so you can feel it. So you can allow the song to come through you. And just remember, you're not judged here, you are fully welcome as you are here. I want to thank Prana Space for hosting tonight.
Thank you for coming.
And the hat behind the camera. And Bashar is going to be drumming with me. Thank you, Bashar. And thank you to every soul who showed up for the journey. Old friends, new friends, old faces, and new faces. So let's take a deep breath together. Cacao gets better every time. Remember today that we are spiritual beings, spiritual humans. We're not just the matter. We're the spirit living through matter. Well, good sense. And lastly, to offer up this experience to what humanity is going through right now. A lot is happening on our planet. A lot of people, humans, beautiful souls are waking up And this is creating a lot of energy and movements and illusions on the surface. So I really want to gather this energy that we activate and experience today and offer it to our beautiful planet, Pachamama. We're going to be singing many songs to her. And so that this healing that we experience can also be shared with all of humanity, and we can be a part of that. So the first song I'm just gonna root, because without roots, we can't fly, we can't journey. But feeling our body and feeling our roots, really exploring that sensation of rooting into the ground. And imagine your spine just extending deep into the ground as you sing. So maybe the first two times you'll have to read it, and then start to feel your body morph like a tree, reaching deep into the earth where you are always supported and always grounded.
To the whole of me, my root.
into our ancient origins, our belonging to the earth, the original tuning in our bodies, in our DNA, in our essence, and just requesting that all the parts start to remember who we are and why we came here. So after each song, you're going to feel a very specific frequency and feeling. Try to receive that without trying to think about it or make sense, without clapping, obviously, so that you can integrate that energy in your body. And one thing I was doing with the Shruti box, it's called overtones. I'm not yet a master at it, but I really appreciate the power of the overtones. They're very healing sounds. Monks use them, a lot of the spiritual workers around the world use them. Basically, when I'm making one sound, at the same time, my body is creating a scale. So I'm going like, it works better with the Shruti box, but you'll start to hear, dum, dum, dum. And anyway, that scale is the natural scale of nature. The scales we hear on most of our instruments are out of tune with nature. So that tone alone, your body starts to receive it and it does its own. Maybe one day you can learn overtones.
Water my blood.
person. Take a deep breath together. The hat all is good. As with all songs, if you don't know it, maybe just listen the first time. And by the second round, we can all share our voices, our energies. This one is for Pachamama, our divine mother, the earth. To move in your body and see what you hear from Pachamama today. The waters are the source of life. All organisms came from water. We came from the waters of our mother's womb. So everything originates in the water. And if the waters we drink and bathe ourselves in are not pure and purified, then we're in trouble. But purifying water is not something you need to hand to an engineer, although we love all the engineers in the room. It's something we can do just with our prayers and our sacred intentions. So this song is a prayer of purification for the waters of the earth, the rivers, the oceans, and even the waters that are here energetically. Masalan, when we go to Wadi Rum, one of my favorite places, and we're going there soon, the mountains are shaped in a way where you feel there was once water there. So the energies of the water are still there, even though the physical manifestation of the water is not something we see and touch. So we can send these prayers to the waters seen and unseen, and the waters that need purification on this planet right now, the oceans, the rivers, and the waters inside us, the waters in our blood, the waters in our being, the waters behind the waters, shall we say. Everything okay over there?
Don't you know again?
imagine with your mind's eye all the waters of the earth getting purified with your song. Crystals clearing, the memories clearing. Going back to source, to origins, to the spring waters of the earth. Anyone else sweating like me? Let's see if we've got any less delicious. Alright, this is a good one. Another very important source of all life, of all nourishment, of all color, of all light, our infinite sun. It's interesting, the sun in different traditions has different gender. In some traditions, it's the masculine, and that's how it's always been in my head. Like, the moon is the grandmother moon, she's feminine, the earth is feminine, and the sun is masculine. But in some traditions, including, I think, ancient Egyptian, the sun is feminine and the earth is masculine. So everything just gets all mixed up together, according to some teachers. Some teachers I learned from. So eventually, it's not about what's male, what's female. It's about what do you feel the sun is? Who do you feel she is? One time I was in Wadiram and I felt she was a grandmother. But she was like this sassy grandmother with an attitude. And I was like, I got your back. And she was like, we were having a moment. And it was interesting because I always thought of it as masculine, father, son. So things are more amorphous. That's about boxing them. And let's try to just connect with the energy of the sun through the song and see who is the sun to you.
I think it actually goes to Shams, is like you're feminine. But
yeah. I love the name Shams. If you ever find me with a daughter called Shams, don't be surprised. Of course, it's my lover in me. We'll add it to the list. This is a fun one, so allow your body to move.
نعمل زقفة.
ليه الزقفة بنعمل الشيطان؟
لا عشان لما الأغنية تخلص لما تزقف بتفرغ الإنرجي. So you wanna bring it inside.
So just
ومن عمل الشيطان.
Try to feel what you're feeling now.
Thank you.
because it's a song about the spirit. And so I want to offer her, through our song, to all the indigenous cultures that have given us these songs, that really still practice being in touch with their spirit and with the land and with the elements. And so we're really lucky today that many people like ourselves preserve these songs and these traditions and these ways of connecting with the earth and with the soul, that today we can have these songs. Even if we don't know what they mean, we can feel them. Who's building some fire? Who's connecting with the waters? Who's feeling more connected to the earth? Anybody feeling the
air.
Spirit?
Air.
The air, flying high.
Yes.
Now that we're connected, we can start to open up to receive. Anybody want to receive?
Yes.
What do you want to receive?
Everything.
Popcorn style, what do you want to receive?
Love,
happiness.
Mm. Connection. Mm.
Success.
What else? You gotta call it if you want it.
Divine life.
Mm.
Clarity.
So let's receive. Capo. problem. Anyone want to hang out until the morning?
Yes.
Oh, this is one of the first ones I really connected with many years ago. Let's take a deep breath together. Shake anything that needs to move.
Yeah.
each one of us with our little mission, big mission, medium mission, holy mission. And each one of us here for a reason.
هاي الأغنية اللي أول مرة شفت مديحة جيت على كان بتغني سيكريت سونز فهاي الأغنية
نعجبت فيها
أغنية ولا مديحة
طريقة تزبيط غريبة
remember when you came I remember why I came. So like I said, a lot of these songs are gathered from all around the world. This one is a Buddhist chant, and it's in the name of Amitabhaya. Amitabhaya is like the awakened one. Buddhayam is your soul, your awakened soul. Dhammayam is the Dharma, so the...
Your mission.
The mission, exactly. And Sanghayam is the sacred community, that's us.
Wow.
So we're singing to our awakened one, we're singing to our mission, and we're singing to our community. Because one without the other two is not the Trinity, and they all need each other, so we're activating them together and celebrating also different traditions through that, who have found a way to speak that truth. That's my couple because he's getting old. And I'm really going to ask if you need to go to the bathroom, go between songs. If you need to move, go between songs because I get a bit, like my energy gets shaken. So please try to respect the sacred space. There's a space hunak fi hada. So can we close the gap? Can we close the gap?
Yes.
Is it locked? Can we lock it? That no one goes in and out? You're all mine.
We lock and my room.
Just try to be discreet between songs, please. witness to all the lineages we belong to and how at the core they're all one. When we sing, we remember it's all part of the same source we've come from, and we will go back to someday, hopefully not too soon.
We have a mission to do.
Again, I don't know about him. The boy was. Today I found the porpoise. With like one word tweaked. لازم نحكي مع سمعين على البورپوس.
Mother's weaving the rainbow, weaving the threads of mine.
We're gonna do this one and we're gonna skip this last one. So in the still of the night, something more calm to start to wind down our energies. To be able to integrate the truth, the activations, the love, the community, the secrets being whispered. So this one, actually the part we're going to sing, it's not written here, it's Jema, again, the great mother, the great source of all, the great nourisher of all, the cosmos, your mothers, your grandmothers, all the lineage of women. Let's take a deep breath together. Let's tune into the silence of the breath. Tune into how you're feeling right now as we start to close our circles. Our spiraling deeper and deeper activations start to settle. Thank you. truth is revealed, all our sorrows will be healed.
Then I know what I'm doing.
It is you. So we're gonna close, just holding each other's hands.
Is it that I hick? Is it not that I hick?
Yeah, if you don't, just put your hand on your heart and request to end. In your mind, if you don't hold someone, just energetically let the energy flow. Okay, so repeat after me. Please let me feel inner peace together.
Please let me feel. Shower the person to our left.
don't touch inappropriately. Unless they want you to. Shower someone across the room. Shower all of humanity that needs this energy to connect for community and love and connection and mission. Aho!
Aho!
Thank you, everybody, for coming. Thank you, beautiful souls. Thank you, Bashar, for joining me. Thank you, Neda, for hosting, and Bahat with the camera. Thank you, my lover, for always supporting. Thank you, everybody who came and sang with us and shared your energy. Without you, this event would not have been this special. Thank you, Mahmoud. Thank you, everybody watching as well. I might be sharing this, so thank you, everyone, for being with us. Take this energy, shower yourself with it, share it with some people you love, share it with all of humanity. Keep connecting with the earth and the elements, and magic will follow. Enjoy.
Thank you, Madiha.
Thank you. And if you want to deal your donation to Neda, please just make sure to find out.
Thank you, Madiha.
Thank you. Yeah, the event has ended now.